The next one is about comorbidities and lifestyle. Those more likely to get severe COVID-19, we are told, are people like me, elderly with diabetes. And elderly, those with comorbidities. Comorbidities means diseased conditions of the body, like diabetes, high blood pressure, cardiovascular disease. And these things are to come together as under one label as metabolic syndrome. And I have listened to one engineer who engineer means his engineering is connected to medical field, and he has put together. Hello, can you? He has put together lots of things, lots of research papers, and he says every heart attack of a non-diabetic, if you check his insulin, you will find that he is insulin resistant, and insulin resistance is the primary cause of inflammation in the body, chronic low-grade inflammation in the body that causes injuries to the arteries. The Center for Disease Control in the USA, the CDC, it has a lifestyle change program because now we have come to realize that our lifestyle is the root cause of all our problems. The Center for Disease Control lifestyle change program is online for the people of USA. They can pay a fee and then get the help of a medical practitioner or someone in the medical field to help them with the day-to-day adjustments of lifestyle. It is not here in India now, as of now. So the understanding is there that most of our problems arise from our lifestyle, whether it is in nature, like atmospheric pollution, the plastics that are piling up in the lakes and rivers, or the cholesterol piling up in our blood vessels, and the ill health that we are experiencing as lifestyle diseases. Here are some of the things which through which this COVID has had so much of an effect, because our immunity is not what it should be. It has eroded a lot. And the things which I am saying now, the points that I am trying to share, are points through which you can keep your health and boost your immunity. And the first one in that is the sun. One thing that interested everyone was that when SARS-CoV-2 entered USA and certain countries of Europe, though COVID-19 had affected everyone, the effect was not universal. The nature and magnitude of the impact was different in different people. The National Geographic of April 24 report that African Americans struggled with disproportionate COVID death toll, which they describe as a toxic storm of severe illness and death that had come in many of the online publications, that lots of African Americans were hospitalized and many of them died. And there are many socioeconomic factors for this, because of they are the minority and they have certain other problems. But one common feature among all those who developed complications and died was that their vitamin D levels were very low. The skin produces vitamin D by absorbing the UVB rays of the sun. Dark-skinned people need much more sunlight than light-skinned people to make the same amount of vitamin D with their skin. I had thought that it was the reverse. I thought we were all in the sunny land, and dark-skinned people would get much more benefit from the sun, but that is not correct. Dark-skinned people need lots more of sunlight than light-skinned people to make the same amount of vitamin D. The dark-skinned people settled in Europe and USA, they all come from tropical areas, and their bodies are adapted to the tropical sun. This situation, which was found in USA, was also there in Sweden among the Somalian immigrants. They also died. Disproportionate amount of severe COVID and death was found in the Somalian immigrants also. Vitamin D is not like vitamin A or vitamin B. It acts like a hormone, and its receptors are found all over the body, including the immune cells. Research has shown that vitamin D deficiency is part of the seasonal flu experienced in many countries, because this seasonal flu happens in winter. when there is less sunlight, less vitamin D, and lower immunity, and more illness. Vitamin D deficiency is also found in those with high blood pressure, poor lung health, psoriasis, and obesity. 10 minutes a day in the sun, between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. is what you need to get enough sunlight. See, I was of the belief that we need to get the early morning or evening sunlight. When the early morning sunlight comes in slanting through the dust layers, and the UVB rays are much less in the early morning and early late and that evening dusk sunlight. What we require is the bright sun between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. and just 10 minutes of it if you can expose your arms and legs, and or if you wear thin clothes with then if you hold your the dress up to the sun, the one layer of it up to the sun, and you can see the sun through it, how much light passes through that cloth, that is the amount of sunlight which will reach your body. So you can get enough sun by going out in the sun for about 10 minutes or 15 minutes by 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. time. UVA from sunlight, this is about UVB, UVA from sunlight, that will release nitric oxide by acting on the nitrates deposited in your skin. And this nitric oxide leads to vasodilation, that keeps your blood vessels dilated. Those who have high blood pressure, if they take sunlight every day, that blood pressure is known to come down. These are all proven things and lifestyle changes that you can have to improve your health. The next thing is food. Food should be healthy and wholesome. As we all know, it should have all the components. We know there are three macronutrients, carbohydrates, proteins, and fats, and the micronutrients which we get from the vegetables and other fruits we eat, vegetables, fruits, and other products that we eat. But food should be healthy and wholesome. The carbohydrates are the major sources of our energy, as we all know. But carbohydrates, we understand, has this the problem with India is that we eat 70% of our plate as carbohydrates. 70% of the calories we get from carbohydrates. They are the major source of our energy. Though there is a keto diet where they make fat, use fat as energy source. That is not accepted by IMA. So in India, we need not talk about keto as an independent body. So carbohydrates are the major source of energy for us. And when carbohydrates, we take in 70% as carbohydrates, we are not able to expend that much energy. 1 gram of carbohydrates has 4 calories. So this if you have to burn those calories, we need to have some exercise. Our body needs to be exercised. And all the things, physical labor which we used to do at home, now they have all been, are being done by external and spending external energy, not by the energy of our bodies. We don't walk anywhere. We drive the car and use petrol. We don't grind or pound rice or anything. That is all done by machines. And even for sweeping and mopping, we have machines. So our body doesn't spend much energy. And if you try to find out how much energy is spent, according generally, what we spend by lying down is around 50 calories, depending on your metabolic rate. If you sit up, you spend up to 70 calories. If you stand up per hour, you spend up to 120 calories. And if you walk around, you spend more depending on the pace of your walk, etc. But generally, people are sitting around watching TV or lying down, especially during this COVID season. And our food gets deposited in our viscera and underneath our skin and among our muscle fibers as fat. And when more carbohydrates come in, when we eat more, that cannot be stored in these places. And because every storage place is full and it overflows into the blood as high glucose. And the insulin also, insulin is our pancreas produces more and more insulin, seeing the high levels of blood sugar in our blood. circulation, and ultimately the body becomes insulin resistant or resistant also. The average person living in the modern world, not one employed in physical labor or doing strenuous exercises, requires 20 calories per kilogram body weight for a day. It must come from a variety of foods, not just from carbohydrates. The proportion of each category of food is important as what foods you eat. This is the food plate. This food plate has been propagated by American Diabetic Association. This is the from the Canadian Diabetic Association. It is not a diabetic food plate. It is the food plate for healthy life. And IMA has also now is also now accepting this as the norm for healthy eating. The plate, as you can see, is half of the plate is made of vegetables and fruits, and one quarter of grains, and the other quarter of proteins. In the proteins, you can have nuts, you can have eggs, you can have whatever you want, like chicken or mutton or whatever you eat, nuts and eggs and cheese and tofu or whatever. And in the carbohydrate portion, the one-fourth of the plate carbohydrate portion, you have to include whole grains only. Don't use maida or refined carbs and the white rice which we get. But even if you use the white rice with this proportion, you will not have a spike in sugar. And a doctor in Pune eat the vegetables and protein first. First the vegetables, then the protein, and then the carbohydrates. You may wonder, if it is carbohydrate, is idli, what about the sambar? Should we eat it first or after? The sambar doesn't count in part of the carbohydrate. So if you eat the vegetables first, that will fill you up and you won't feel tempted to eat more of the carbohydrate. If the vegetables will take time to digest, it is full of fiber, and fiber is very important. And the proteins require a lot of energy to digest. The digestion process itself will consume almost as much energy as you have consumed through the protein. But too much protein will load your kidneys. So protein is important, but only one fourth of the plate. And vegetables and fruits should comprise of the major portion of your plate. And the vegetables should not be starchy vegetables like potatoes. They should only potatoes and peas. They are starchy vegetables. They will also contain carbohydrates. They can be eaten, but not as the full portion of vegetables. And fruits also better to have the low glycemic fruits. But those non-diabetics can also eat mangoes and pineapple and all the high glycemic fruit. So this is the food plate. Half of it is vegetables and fruits, a quarter or up to 30% as whole grains, and 20% protein. The 30% whole grains, you can we can use even millets also. Millets, there are millet doshas, idlis, then besan laddu. That those are not laddu, that you should try to avoid added sugar. But we get most of our micronutrients from the vegetables. The vitamins and minerals that we require for daily living, we can get through the vegetables. Further that, in addition to the vitamins and minerals, the vegetables and fruits have a certain phytochemicals. These are the chemicals which give the color and the smell to the fruit. They all have distinctive smells and colors. And these phytochemicals are very useful to us. We have heard of carotenoids. Carotenoids are the carotene, we say, in a carrot. Those carotenoids, reduce your incidence of cancer. They reduce inflammation in the body, inhibit cancer growth, inhibit cardiovascular diseases, and boost immunity. Same, another set of chemicals in the vegetables and fruits are flavonoids and anthocyanins. They also fight inflammation, tumor growth, and are associated with lower blood pressure. These are just few of the benefits of the food plate. You are getting enough of carotenoids and anthocyanins and flavonoids, and these will help you to prevent cancer developing in your body or lifestyle diseases help developing in your body. The leafy greens are also full of carotene. The thing is, we may think that let us have breakfast with the vegetables and fruits and lunch with protein and dinner with carbs. That is not such recommended by the IMA or the CDC or anybody. What they recommend is that every meal should be a balanced meal. Every meal should have all three components. These components have their own value in the digestion process also, which if I explain, it will be too lengthy. And as far as possible, the carbohydrates must come from, as I said, they must come from whole grains. And those who are sick and or are on medication, if you are on medication for diabetes, if you migrate from a high carb diet to a low or a medium carb diet as shown in the food plate, you are going to have a drop in your blood sugar. So those who do that, they have to either take the advice of their doctors. There are lifestyle doctors also who suggest lifestyle change treatments. So even in India, there is one in Thiruvananthapuram. And they will monitor your blood sugar, or you have to monitor it yourself before and after meal and make suitable adjustments in your medication to control the blood sugar falls and hypoglycemia. That is more dangerous than hyperglycemia, as diabetics know. And those who take medicines should be consistent in their eating pattern. They should not take lots of food during lunch and less food in dinner or anything like that. It should be consistent. Whatever you, the quantity you eat one day, that same quantity you should try to eat at every day, because the medications are the same, and the medication's effect will be either it will cause your blood sugar or your blood pressure things to spike, or it is not good for a person on medication to be inconsistent in their meals. They should have regular meals. Then soluble and insoluble fibers. That is the next aspect. Soluble fiber and insoluble fiber. We know a lot of about soluble fibers because we are told that oats has soluble fiber. You should eat oats. It will reduce your cholesterol, etc. We know about insoluble fiber, which we can feel when we chew those things like the skin of the apple has lots of insoluble fiber. The cell walls, they are all made of insoluble fiber. And these fibers are very important to us because they create bulk in the colon. Your stools will have bulk if you have lots of fiber, and it will pass easily. You will not get problems like constipation, etc. If your diet is balanced and you have a reasonable amount of fiber in your food. But insoluble fiber is of even greater importance. Insoluble fiber is what you see. One of the insoluble fibers is pectin. We have heard about pectin. When we make jams, we add commercial pectin or papaya to it. Papaya, apple, everything has, these fruits have lots of pectin in it. And we take, the diabetics take this asafoetida soap in the morning, or they take certain vegetables like okra, lady's finger soaked in water. And these leave behind a gooey substance. That gooey substance is the pectin. And the pectin will line the stomach walls, and that gooey substance will line your stomach walls. And when food goes down, the absorption is limited. And this insoluble fiber, which doesn't create bulk, but it goes down to your colon, further down to your colon. The gut bacteria feeds on these, and they release certain things like SFCA, short chain fatty acids, and other byproducts, which are very useful to the body. They are the food for the walls of the colon, walls of your large intestine. And the health of the large intestine is very much a concern for everybody, because now colon cancer is on the up. Many people are getting colon cancers. If you have a diet full of...
Excuse me, Susan. We have 4 minutes left, so you'll have to hurry up a bit.
Hurry up. Okay, sir. Okay, ma'am. So the fiber is very important. Another thing is epigenetics. We think that we are genetically more to have cancer or diabetes, but that is not true. There are so many bacteria or bacteria living in our colon. They can, by the production of these byproducts, they can shut off the expression of certain harmful genes. And this is as part of the epigenetic study, so that soluble fiber is very important. Our spices is another thing that we can pay attention to. Our spices, we have been, this is traditional wisdom. We have been taught about the spices and their benefits, and we are very familiar with this. Hydration is very important. We have to not to neglect drinking enough water. Then intermittent fasting and autophagy, that is something which needs a little time. Intermittent fasting is not, whenever you are not eating, you are fasting. So you have dinner and then you have breakfast. The in-between period is fasting. That is why we say it is breakfast. And intermittent fasting is the time when your body takes rest, when it is no longer paying attention to digesting the food or absorbing the food, and it is using the time to rest and repair itself. And that is very important. And it is the time when it when there is sufficiently long fasting period. There isn't food in the body. The body eats its own the useless cells, which has become broken down, which are not useful to the body, and which there are parts of the cells which are worn out or which are irregular. The body eats those as its own food, and that will prevent tumor growth and cancers. And in 2016, the Nobel Prize for Physiology was for finding the mechanism of autophagy. So the fast we had traditionally, religious fast, everything is important. You have to have fast in your life, unless you are on medication, when you can't fast. And there is also the circadian rhythm. The body has a clock, sun, the same as the sun, because we are not nocturnal animals.
Look, puri India se ladies baithi.
So try to eat during daytime and don't postpone your heavy dinner to 9
o'clock. Batao kitni baithi hain. 70 ladies baithi.
Stress is another important thing you have to control. And there are many methods of controlling stress, getting closer to nature, talking with your friends or having WhatsApp chats, video chats. Those will help. And exercise, as we know, we don't need a gym to exercise. We can use stretch bands or weights. And instead of weights, you can use bottles, Coke bottles filled with water as weights, and have and use your and do exercises. There are many exercises on the that are available on the internet, and you can with as a family also you can exercise. Then relaxing and letting go, that is also important. Yoga, meditation, prayer, all these help you to relax and let go. Then listening to music, getting close to nature, even on your balcony. I find it very releasing and relaxing when I go on the terrace and watch the birds or the trees. That will itself is that is a relaxing action, because nature has a way to connect to you. And the last, and then you are worth it. Indulge yourself, learn something.